Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. We're going to go over place value for whole numbers in this video, but before we start, let's think about this. Before there was a need to write large numbers, there were various ways of writing numerals. One was this tally system. For instance, to write the number 24, we have this tally you see right here. Most of you are probably familiar with this. This would be 5, another 5, another 5, another 5. That's 20 plus 4 more strokes. So this was made up of these little symbols that you see here, and you could easily read that as 24. And we still use this today often. For instance, if you're trying to count a few things up, it's a quick way of tallying a vote, etc. But there's a problem if you're trying to write a really large number. So let's say you had this number, 5,324, which hopefully you're familiar with reading that number. Well, if you try to do that using this tally system, it would just take way too long. You couldn't fit it on a page even. So this system that we're used to, this 5,324, it actually incorporates something pretty important called place value. So this doesn't mean 5 plus 3 plus 2 plus 4, for instance. Depending on where the placement of a digit is, it represents something. So this 4, this is really 4 ones. This is called the ones place. The 2 is in what's called the tens place. This would be like 2 tens. The 3 is in the hundreds place, and the 5 is in the thousands place. So we have 5,300, 2 tens, and 4 ones. Now you could think about this as many. If you had, I wish I had this, $5,324, you might have 5 $1,000 bills, 3 $100 bills, 2 $10 bills, and 4 ones. So this really represents 5 $1,000 bills. I don't even know if there's $1,000 bills, but if there were, there would be 5 of them because I've never had one in my hand. $300 bills. And we've got 2 $10 bills. And we'd have $1 bill. So the placement of these digits, remember the digits are from 0 to 9, is very important. What's also important about a place value system is you might have a 0. 0 is really important. Let's say you didn't have any $10 bills. Then you have to have this placeholder of 0 to tell you there's no $10 bills. If you just wrote 534, you would think that would be 534, 5 100s, 3 tens, and 4 ones. So here's how the place value system works. I've gone up to, let's say, the millions place. What we have is starting from the right, there's the ones, the tens, the hundreds, the thousands, the 10,000s, the 100,000s, the 1 million. So if I kept going to the left, there would be the 10 million, the 100 million, etc. So the interesting thing is in each group, there's a ones, tens, and a hundreds. So first, in this group, we don't really call it anything, but there's ones, tens, hundreds. But notice here, there's 1,000, 10,000, 100,000. And then in the millions, there will be the 1 million, 10 million, 100 million. Then we'll go to the billions and the trillions, etc. So there's always this grouping of three, and that is why we have the comma. Now, another way of writing these numbers is using exponents, and I'm going to preview what an exponent in power is. An exponent of power is a little number written to the upper right of a number called the base. So if you see how I have a 10 here, this is called the base, and a little 3 to the upper right, that's called the exponent. And this is what it means. 10 with that little 3 up there means you take the base 10 and you multiply it by itself 3 times, whatever the exponent is. So this is what it means when we have whole numbers. So I'm just going to show you how it works with whole numbers where the base is 10. So 10 with a little 3, 10 times 10 times 10, or 1,000. Okay. 10 with a little 2, we could read this as 10 to the second power, or 10 squared, means 10 times 10, which is 100. 10 to the sixth power means 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. You're going to have 10 multiplied by itself 6 times, which is 1 million. So here's the thing. Anytime you have 10 to some number, let's do 10 to the fourth power. Well, look at the pattern up here. When you had 10 to the third power, notice you had 1 with 3 zeros for the answer. When you have 10 to the second power, you have a 1 with 2 zeros. When you have 10 to the sixth power, you ended up 1 with 6 zeros. So the pattern is 10 to the fourth is a 1. The answer ends up being 1 with 4 zeros. How about 10 to the first power? That would be a 1 with 1 zero. And here's the tricky one, since we're doing whole numbers. If you have 10 to the zero power, the answer just ends up being 1 with no zeros. So if you haven't learned about exponents before, this is the basic definition of it when you're taking at least 10 to some whole number, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And there's a lot more to it than you may learn in other sections of arithmetic or pre-algebra. This number 10 is the same thing as 10 to the first power. 100 is 10 squared, 10 to the second power. This will be 10 cubed, 10 to the fourth, 10 to the fifth, and 10 to the sixth. So basically, this exponent means, for 10 cubed, 10 times 10 times 10, which is 1,000. Now, you see this pattern? It goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The exponents go up. So this very first one is actually 10 to the 0. Now, if you haven't had any algebra yet, this will make more sense as you go along. But for now, I'm just showing it to you as a pattern. So these place values here also could be written as powers of 10. And that's useful because it's kind of hard to keep writing these big numbers. So it might look like this instead. If I write the place value in powers of 10, I could sort of fit more on the page, as you can see. So you start off with 10 to the 0, and what that means is just the number that's 100, 10, and 1. 10 to the 0 is actually equal to 1. This concept, 10 to the 0 equals 1, will be clear once you're working with the laws of exponents in algebra. All right, so let's look at this place value system. And let's say we had the number, we'll just fill it in up here, how about 5, 0, 2, 1, 4. All right, so in other words, you're looking at this number. The expanded form is understanding what each of these place values is. What we say is the 5 is in the 10 to the 4th place. So that's 5 10,000s. So you could write that as 50,000. I don't have anything in the thousands place except 0. So I've got 2 in the hundreds place, so this is 200. I have 1 in the tenths place, so I have 110, and I have 4. So if you add these numbers up together, it actually is this exact same number. Okay. So when you put the 5 here, you have to remember what it really stands for is 50,000. When you have the 2 here, it really stands for 200. The 1 stands for 110. Which is just 10, and the units, or the ones place, right, is just 4. So when we add those numbers up, it really represents the number 50,214. These stand for the same thing. And this is called expanded form if you write it like this. 50,000 plus 200 plus 10 plus 4. We call that the expanded form of the number. Right, so here's one for you to try. Write 6,570 in expanded form. Right, so what's that going to be? 6 is in the thousands place, so we have 6,000 plus 5 is in the hundreds place, 500. 7 is the tens place, 7 tens is 70. We don't have any ones. Notice you don't have to write plus 0. All right, so this is now the expanded form of 6,570. All right, let's just do one more thing. So here are the place values that I wrote out. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands. I didn't write out the words, okay, but I want you to think about the words now. And also, here it is in the exponential form if you want to see that. And the question is, how would we state the place value of the four in each of these numbers? All right, so in other words, four, depending on its placement, what does it really stand for? All right, try this on your own first. See if you can write out in words what the place value is. Okay, so for the first one, what is the 4 in? Well, we've got 1, 10, 100s, so it's in the hundreds place. All right, next one. So that's in the hundreds place. What about this 4? 1, 10, 100,000. Or what you could say is, well, it's in that grouping with the thousands. And so it's in the first, remember this goes 1, 10, 100, 1,000, so it's 1,000. So this is in the thousands place. All right. And what about this last one? Where's that 4? It's right in the ones. All right, in the next video, what we'll do is learn how to write the numbers in words and also how to take a number in words and write it as our regular number. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.